Hello everyone, good evening. I am Purnima from Fertility Dost, and today we have Dr. Rutuja with us. She is Senior Infertility Specialist, Parency IVF Center, Bangalore. Good evening, ma'am.
Hello. Thank you for having me again on Fertility Dost. It is one of my favorite forums. I just love following it. And congratulations, you have crossed 10,000, I think, deliveries through you. You have helped them having babies. Many congratulations to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. And here at this forum, I don't think that Dr. Rutuja needs any further detailing from my side. And she's the regular specialist, I would say regular visitor. I won't say because she's a family now with us. So she's a regular family member with us at Fertility Dose. And today with Dr. Rutuja, we are going to discuss about very sensitive thing. I should say it's a kind of stigma. We want to talk about it, but yes, we avoid talking about it. Why is it so? Why donor cycle we talk about in hush-hush voices? We never want to discuss about our cycle tabooed as a donor cycle. Why is it so? हमारा IVF करवाने का मकसद है कि we want a family. तो क्या उस IVF को हम categorize कर सकते हैं सिर्फ cycle or donor? Why is it so that we always think, oh God, donor? कुछ तो अजीब होगा. So today at our forum, we really want to break this taboo. We want to discuss these terms with our viewers. And I really appreciate if you have any queries related to this word, donor cycle, please come forward, talk to us, discuss this. It is not a bad word. ये ऐसी चीज है जो आपको discuss करने पे ही समझ आएगी. So I would start the session and first of all, Dr. Rutuja, as I said, this is a kind of stigma, donor cycle. But
exactly.
Is there any categorization of these cycles, like what kind of donor cycles we need and how can we see, yes, this couple needs donor oocyte, this couple needs donor sperm or donor embryo. So you can suggest these types of cycles and why the patient needs these cycles.
Okay. So when we talk about donor programs itself, first of all, patient itself is not convinced or ready to accept that, you know, there is problem in themselves. It's that, you know, they cannot have their own eggs or their own sperms to have their own baby. So definitely talking about donor cycles, hamesha, you know, in, especially in India, people are not that accepting kinds. They take time to accept, okay, I should go for a donor egg or donor oocyte programs or donor sperm programs or even embryo donations for that matter. So there are certain category of groups in which directly donor programs are being advised and there are certain category of groups which eventually ends up into a donor program. So donor programs can be donor oocyte, donor sperm and donor embryos. So first, let us talk about donor eggs because that is most commonly spoken about, talked about, and as we are even parallelly talking about poor AMH and embryo pooling, but there is another side to it, like males who are born with zero sperm count, that is called as azoospermia. Similarly, there are women with premature ovarian failure or ovarian insufficiency. So these women don't have a normal number of eggs in their ovaries or they are born with nearly no eggs. In such situations, what happens? Their AMH is like less than 001, less than 002, like that. There are hardly any follicles there even to go for minimal stimulation or embryo pooling. Such women who don't have eggs will not have their periods also. So without hormonal cycles, they will not menstruate also. So because of non-ovulation, even the uterine size goes on shrinking. So this happens even in low AMH. But depends how low your AMH is, that your uterine size will go on shrinking. So such women, we have to advise directly for donor cycles because there are no eggs. Similarly, the, you know, equivalent side to the male side, if we see, there is something called as azoospermia. Azoospermia means there are no sperm in the semen. In such situations, there are again two bifurcations in which there is something called as TESA or PESA. We try to extract sperms from the testicles or from the epididymis. But what if we don't get sperm from the testicles or epididymis? What is the next thing? Because we have eggs, we have uterus, we don't have sperm.
Right.
In such situations also, we directly advise the couple to go for donor sperms. So this is one condition in women in which we directly advise, that is ovarian insufficiency or premature ovarian failure. Second is azoospermia with no sperm found in epididymal or testicular samples. That is first and direct indication. Second comes where, you know, there is low AMH. You tried embryo pooling, you tried, you know, going for self eggs, but either you are not ending up into a blastocyst or day 3 embryos are also not formed. So let's start from basic. When you are low AMH, you can come across something called as empty follicle syndrome. So woman right. comes to us, we tell, madam, your AMH is very low. Your AFC is very low. Do teen hi ande dikh rahe hain. But she's not ready to go. So we do minimal stim or we do a proper stimulation and we get empty follicles. Means we see the egg, but there is no oocyte inside it. Ande hi nahi aaye, to ICSI kiska hoga? Correct.
Right.
So it indicates that the AMH is so low that now the quality of the oocyte is deteriorating to an extent that follicle is forming without a oocyte, mature M2 oocyte in it. Okay. In such situations, we advise a patient to think about a donor program. Second situation is we got oocyte, but we are not getting embryos. Okay, if you are affordable from a good socioeconomic background, you can still try 2 to 3 cycles with self and then take a call. But what if you have a limited amount of money or your financial background is not that strong, with lot of difficulty, you arrange money for one cycle only and it ends up into no embryo formation or no oocyte retrieve. In such situations also, we advise them that next cycle you go for donor program so that they only have to, pay for the donor and the stimulation of that. But at least they'll get a good grade embryos to go for a proper embryo transfer. Right. Because if when we talk about donors are, there is a agencies for that. There are proper ICMR guidelines about it, which government has formed, that how the agency should recruit a donor, how a donor can become an egg donor. So someone, we cannot just go and say, I want to become an egg donor. We have to scrutinize her. She should be married, previous 1 or 2 normal children. Age should be between 21 to 30. With all the parameters normal, from AMH to blood to all infection profile to karyotyping, and even psychological analysis should be done ideally, and then only they can become a donor. And you cannot directly take a donor. Government agencies are there. You have to select a donor from that. So donors, when we take donor eggs, oocytes, they are young girls with a normal AMH.
Right.
So the quality of oocyte itself will be better. So the embryo formations will be better. And since she has proven her fertility before, such oocytes, when we use, the chances of them giving you pregnancy rate are better than, you considering with low AMH where the quality of oocyte itself is low. So definitely one failed IVF or sometimes a low AMH with no follicles obtained or no embryos formed, we give option of donor eggs. Third is multiple, there is everything normal, embryos are normal, but there is an implantation failure or there is a genetical abnormality history, or you did an IVF and baby was down, so something else. Though that there also we advise for donor program. Another very rare but yes existing situation is karyotyping abnormal of the mother. So multiple abortions or recurrent implantation failures or, baby died after birth and all, we do karyotypings. Once we do karyotyping, there is some deletions in the chromosomes which are repetitively coming in the pregnancy when the egg and the sperm meet. Baby is becoming a dominant disease holder, which is leading to the death of the baby or abortions of the babies. In such situations, even if your AMH is normal, even if you are young, you having a normal baby, chances are very less. So such situations, we definitely send them for genetic counseling. Look at the percentage of you carrying a normal baby. But in such cases, if they go for donor program, you are changing those defective genes. And the chances of you conceiving and having a healthy outcome is better. So in such situations also, we advise for a donor cycle. Then next situation comes in which you had done embryo pooling, you did transfers and all, but still result has not come. That in that also donor cycles help. So first is premature ovarian failure. Second is genetical abnormality. Third is low AMH. You tried, but there was empty follicle or poor embryos formed or multiple cell failures. We advise donor cycles. Now, coming to success rate of donor cycles, it has been observed that women above age of 37, the chances of them conceiving or the fertility rate of such women conceiving through their own oocyte starts falling drastically, and genetical abnormality risk also starts growing drastically. So in such situations, when we go for a donor cycles also, the success rate is much better, maybe 60%. If you see data, some are stating from 50 through 63, some are saying 60 to 70% that they may conceive successfully with a live birth rate. So it is basically choice to the patient if they want to. But if AMH is low, you have tried everything, I think donor program you should consider. But the thing is, people think mere ande nahi hai to mere genes nahi rahenge. But woman has to understand that to have a genes procreating further, even if you carry it 9 months in your body, it is formed with your own flesh. It is formed with your own blood. You are carrying it 9 months. Just the genes does not, you know, identify a person as your own. When you are giving birth to it, itself makes you a mother. So we should not carry these taboos that only my gene line should be forwarded. Yes, if everything good and then you are trying to it, very good. But if it is not happening, why you should avoid yourself from considering a donor cycle and, you know, giving yourself the joy of, you know, carrying a pregnancy and having your own child. Right. Then coming to me. Yeah, you were saying something.
Actually, I was thinking about this empty follicle you just discussed. तो ये जो empty follicle है, ये क्या हमें normal ultrasound या TVS में पता चलता है कि, और we should go for IVF and then we can say कि yes, these follicles are empty.
Empty follicle syndrome, you have to diagnose it. Okay, where how to diagnose it? You will get to know only when you do the pickup. Okay. And now empty follicle syndrome can happen at both the extremes. PCOS, multiple follicle, AMH in two digits. You are seeing like 30, 40, 50 follicles, but no oocyte coming from it. They are empty. Another scenario is next, exact opposite of that, in which the AMH is low, hardly 2-3-4-5 follicles hai, 7 follicles hai. You try picking it up, there is no oocyte in it. Because both the places, whether it is PCO or it is poor AMH, the quality of the oocyte is the problem. Right. Now, empty follicular syndrome can be of two, because can be two reasons. One is this quality is bad, where you are anticipating a empty follicle syndrome. Second is when you give stimulation and you give a trigger injection. If the trigger injection is not given properly, because the efficacy of the trigger injection, it is temperature maintained, it has to be a proper one. And sometimes what happens, there are two kinds of triggers. One is decapeptyl trigger or the deca trigger, which we all prefer today in today's generation to prevent OHSs. Other is HCG or recombinant Ovitral trigger. But HCG and Ovitral is ideal. But if we give that, the chances of women going into OHSs are very high. So to prevent OHSs, ovarian hyperstimulation, these days we all give a decapeptyl trigger. So sometimes decapeptyl trigger does not mature the oocytes. Sometimes there is no LH surge, so there is no maturation of oocyte and you don't get a oocyte. Or there the what you say, the temperatures are not maintained and the efficacy of the trigger itself is not correct. So how to correct this situation? Like, we people who have our own IVF centers, we call our patients to take injections here. So it is not one patient who is taking that. Every day there are patients.
Every,
so the batch is same. So meko kal us site mila, aaj us site nahi mila. So I know it is not fault of the injection. It is the fault of the oocyte quality or the AMH or PCOS. And definitely when an empty follicle comes, we check P4, we check LH, we do a UPT and see whether there was LH surge or not. So there can be empty follicle in two ways. One is if the efficacy, because many people give injections at home. People sometimes buy from the pharmacy, and nowadays online craze is going off of and hormones. So the temperature chain, if it is not maintained, it will not mature the oocyte. And the trigger itself is given for converting M1, immature oocyte, to mature oocyte and let it release. Just before it ruptures, we are trying to take it out. So in scanning, we cannot see oocyte. Though oocyte is the largest cell of our body, it is only seen under microscope. You can hazily, sometimes if you have a very high-end scan machine, you may see little bit of haziness inside the follicle. But nobody can see a oocyte in a scan. Nobody can predict the follicle syndrome before. Because what we see in the scan is a follicle. Inside the follicle is our microscopic oocyte. And now this oocyte can be mature, can be immature. When we see it in the microscope, our embryologist tells it is these are these many number of M2s, this many number of M1, and this many number of germinal vesicles. These are the process of maturation. So whenever you do pickup, you don't get all mature oocytes. There will be certain 10%, 15% quotient of M1s and germinal vesicles also. But only M2 can get fertilized by a sperm and give us embryos. So our target is to get more M2s. So an empty follicle, that is the thing. Once an empty follicle, the chances of it coming again are very high. So that time patient has to be mentally prepared that again go for a stimulation and going through that 10 days of stimulation injection, again an anesthesia, again ending up into no oocyte, and again another second IVF cycle fail without an embryo transfer.
Right.
Practically, there is no oocyte only, and you become one IVF failure without a actual good embryo transfer to call you a failure. So to take second time that hit again is what the couple has to decide. We can only advise donor that time. I love talking to you. I am in love with you anyway. The way you communicate to the people and you relate to the people is commendable.
थैंक यू मैम. नहीं, मैंने आपको शुरू में ही बताया था कि हमारी कम्युनिटी, हमारा फोरम, यू आर अ फैमिली टू अस. सो एंड
आई फील एट होम हियर. सो आई आल्सो लाइक टॉकिंग हियर एंड आई रियली
तभी हमने इतना बोल्ड टॉपिक रखा था आपके लिए कि वी रियली वांट.
व्हेन यू सेंड दिस आई न्यू यू वांट मी टू टॉक ऑन दिस. it is really, if you feel I can talk on this, even I want to talk on controversial topics which majority people are hesitant to talk, because someone has to bring the change in the society. So I always tell that if I have to change something in the society, I should start it from me, then only I can accept from the others.
Right, bilkul theek. यही हम चाहते हैं कि लोग खुल के आए, बात करें, क्योंकि जब तक हमसे बात नहीं करेंगे, आप बोलेंगे नहीं, हम आपको उस चीज का सोल्यूशन ही नहीं दे पाएंगे. सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है आपका कम्युनिकेट करना हमारे साथ. एंड रिमेम्बर दिस, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क एनीथिंग जो आपको लगता है आप अपने नाम से नहीं पूछ सकते, प्लीज सेंड अस एनोनिमस क्वेरी. वी आर हेयर टू हेल्प यू आउट. ऐसा नहीं है कि कुछ चीजें आप सोचें कि कहीं ना कहीं फोरम से निकल के आती रहेंगी. नहीं, आप अपने सवाल, अपने क्वेश्चंस खुल के पूछिए. सो हाँ जी, आपकी आवाज थोड़ी कम आ रही है मैम.
डोंट बी हेजिटेंट, एंड दिस इज अ ब्यूटीफुल फोरम. आई थिंक पीपल शुड कम आउट एंड टॉक, बिकॉज दे विल गेट जेन्युइन हेल्प. initially all this was not available, and so much of trauma and taboos women has gone through. At least we are having these things available at our fingertips in our home. I think every woman should utilize it rather than, you know, succumbing to it themselves without sharing it to anyone. So please talk is what I would suggest, and it's a beautiful forum to talk. You'll definitely get help is what I feel.
Yes, thank you. So thank you, Dr. Rutuja. Thank you so much for talking with us and talking about a beautiful subject. Beautiful इसलिए क्योंकि हम बात ही नहीं करना चाहते इसके लिए, क्योंकि जो चीजें छुपी हैं वो कभी ना कभी सामने आए, और उनका सामने आना इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट. सो दिस सेशन आई सीरियसली वॉन्ट पीपल टू लिसन इट अगेन एंड अगेन. को रिलेट कीजिए, कुछ समझिए, कुछ सोचिए, कहीं आप कुछ गलत तो नहीं कर रहे, और अगर गलत कर रहे हैं तो प्लीज उसको सुधारिए. एंड जैसे डॉक्टर रुतुजा ने बोला, प्लीज टॉक, कम आउट, बात कीजिए. सो थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग. ओके, बाय बाय.